thanks again for tuning in for another episode of Community Connection. I'm your host, Ian Jones, and today our guests are from Oakland University, Jay Reid and Kristin Rohrbeck. They are here to discuss with us Oakland University's Center of Autism's Practical Film Workshop for Adults with Autism and Other Developmental Disabilities. So, Jay, Kristin, thanks again for your time, and I just want to start by saying, go Grizzlies. All
right. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for having us, Ian.
Likewise. So let's actually start off with Jay. We're going to go over your bio and background if you want to share that with us today.
Certainly. My background is in education. I have a BS from Eastern Michigan University. I also have a master's in film and production from the American Film Institute in Los Angeles, California.
Very good. And you, Kristin?
My background is in psychology, so I have my master's in developmental psychology, and I've been working now with OU Cares for a number of years.
Very impressive. So, how many years, Kristin, would you say, just offhand?
How many years?
With Oakland University.
I've been there just about going on 3 years now.
Oh, very good.
With the Center for Autism.
Very good. Now, you were saying that you're actually overseeing the OU Cares department, right?
So I'm the program coordinator for the Center for Autism's Outreach Services. So I help manage the programs, the recreational programs that we have, our sports programs for individuals on the spectrum from very young ages all the way up through adulthood. So from ages 3 through adults, camps, some of the other employable skills programs that we have. And Jay then is in charge of the film workshop that we offer.
Yes. Jay, let's start with that actually. Tell us more about what your job is in that department and what that entails and why that's such a great program for Oakland University.
Sure. I'm the program director for the Practical Film Workshop. And within 20 weeks, we have students and we teach them employability skills through the vehicle of filmmaking. So there are certain things they are learning, such as communication, taking critiques, accepting feedback, that go into them learning about pre-production to post-production aspects of filmmaking. So anywhere from script writing to producing to directing, lighting, cinematography, cover the whole gamut.
Wow.
And 20 weeks, at the end of the 20 weeks, the students actually walk away with a thesis project that they can kind of have as their own for a calling card as well. So it's a very intense process. It's very, in my opinion, I think it's a fun process as well.
Oh, absolutely.
To be engaged. It's an edutainment, if you will. I try and keep things fun, but at the same time, you're learning things that relate to the film industry that also are employable skills for working in another genre of work.
Yeah, very broad, so to speak.
Very broad, exactly.
Yeah, those technical skills as well as the communication I'll learn from that are definitely ideal. I couldn't agree more with you on that.
Yeah.
So what kind of films would you say that are covered? You mentioned something for the thesis to add to their portfolio.
Yes. Well, the process goes in, we start with the pre-production of the script writing. So we literally map out the characters, what their plight is, their story. There's a three-act story structure that a lot of screenplays are based upon. On that we model in regards to our students, so we build our story for our project.
Okay.
Like for example, our current project is Worldwide Wishes, which is kind of like be careful what you wish for because it may come true, but that's not
catchy.
yeah. For ultimate bliss, type in your wish. That's our slogan for the movie. But it's an opportunity for the students. Again, they had a hand with creating the story. Casting, we had an opportunity to cast some OU students to play some of the roles in the project as well.
Okay.
So it's a very hands-on process where, you know, the students roll up their sleeves and get their hands dirty and they get involved. But the message is for them to learn these employable skills that they can take wherever they want to go in life. That's
absolutely
the most important thing, to improve their quality of life.
Yeah, you have to love that hands-on experience and also just
Definitely.
The creative mindset behind it, too.
So right.
Very good. Now, I caught the interview on CNN
yes.
with Joey Travolta, which I found out is actually John Travolta's brother.
His older brother.
mind telling us how he actually got involved and what he does per se with this program as well.
Well, I'm going to hand that over to Kristin in regards to his involvement. I know they go back, I believe it's 10 years.
But, okay.
That is has been the cornerstone. He started with the film camps, but I'm gonna let Kristin answer
sure.
that question.
All right. So Joey actually started film camps through Oakland University Center for Autism, OU Cares, 10 years ago. So this is going to be his 10th year in 2015 that he comes and brings the film camp, which is really exciting. Mm. And that's a two-week camp that happens every August, and we bring 11 to 18-year-olds on the spectrum. So it's a little bit younger than the film workshop. So we bring 11 to 18-year-olds on the autism spectrum together, and they learn from Joey and his crew everything about filmmaking that they can in those 2 weeks. They create a film, which is really exciting. And then what happens is Joey takes the material back to California, where he comes from, and they put together the movie, and we offer a big red carpet film premiere every October. So that's kind of the background with Joey. And what happened was, from the film camps a few years ago, when the current director of OU Cares, her name's Kathy Sweeney, when she began with OU Cares, she has a very great background in business and employment. So she started talking to Joey, and Joey had actually started in California the film workshop. So that was where it first started. And she said, hey, why don't we offer something like this in Michigan? We have a number of adults on the spectrum. We need to be helping them getting employment, and that's, you know, where we need to go in the future, in the direction for helping people who are on the spectrum. So she talked to Joey, and they made it happen. We were really lucky to get funding from the state of Michigan through the Department of Community Mental Health, a great grant from them to start up the film workshop, and it started in February 2014. And the rest is history. It's been extremely successful, and we've been very happy.
Fantastic. Sounds like it was meant to be, how those connections just kind of all came together, and everything has worked its way out, itself out from there.
Definitely.
Yeah, wonderful. No, that sounds like a great, great experience. For them to actually say that they've, you know, learned from someone in the industry as well, that's actually just him giving back to that. That's amazing.
One of the great things that we've seen too is some of those kids who've gone through the film camp in previous years, now they're with Jay in the film workshop, so they've taken it to the next level when they started their interest with our film camp with Joey, and now they're with Jay at the workshop learning employable skills.
Wow. All right. Well, Jay, since we're actually talking about employable skills now, thank you, Kristin. You guys cover like a job training as far as this program goes. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, it's not really a job training program. It's a practical film workshop where the students have a viable interest in the different facets of filmmaking, as I mentioned before, like screenwriting, producing, right, directing. And we capitalize on their interest to show them the mechanics, the ins and outs. We have five very talented instructors that cover each discipline, and we cover the different aspects of things that you may not see on a movie set or believe would go into making a movie, like building flats. So you're taking a hammer and a nail, and you're working, and at the same time, those skills, you know, you hammer anything at home when you're putting up a picture or, you know, that type of thing. So
right. It
goes, although the disciplines of filmmaking, the point I'm trying to make is those disciplines of filmmaking that they do learn go into those employable skills, the things that you would do every day in regards to communication, how to speak to someone tactfully, being taking critiques and accepting feedback from others, that type of thing. Because just as on a film set, you are collaborating with everyone.
Right.
And just if you were to work for a corporation. So it's the same mentality that the students get, that exposure of just collaborating, communicating, things of that nature.
So. I see. So it's again, it's more so preparing them to actually be ready for that kind of environment.
Correct.
I see.
It's not necessarily at the end of the 20 weeks where they're ready for, you know, there's a job waiting for them, but it gives them those tools of the trade to seek employment, to go out and volunteer, or to, you know, if they want to come back in, they're more than welcome to re-enroll and be involved in that whole creative process.
Yeah, no, it sounds like you guys definitely cover a lot over 20 weeks, which is great. And I can see how that will definitely prepare them to compete in markets such as California, even here in Michigan, and other film-based markets for sure.
Definitely.
One thing I do want to mention as well is that we are teaching them employable skills where they may get jobs in the film and media industry, and that's wonderful. But what's really special about the program that we're offering is that we're not only teaching the adults that go through the program those skills, we're also teaching them the employable skills, the employment abilities that they're going to need to go into any profession and any job.
Yeah,
so
yes.
They need to be able to communicate. They need to be able to take critiques. They need to learn responsibility and some of those other interpersonal skills as well that they can take into any kind of job environment, not only in the film and media industry. So that's what's really important to note as well, and we're really excited to be doing.
I can definitely see that. I mean, I'm excited myself. I actually want to come check on one of these classes.
You're more than
Please
welcome.
Please do.
We welcome visitors anytime, anytime.
I'll definitely be in touch. The chat.
We've had some great visitors this far, right?
Yes, we've had guest speakers talk about photography.
We have a person
who's coming in and spoke about script supervising, which is basically when you're taking a take of a movie, noting the continuity aspects, like if my character picks up a cup with a left hand or right hand in a certain take, those type of details. Again, it's a kind of a glimpse as to the certain tasks and things that you wouldn't think go into making a movie, but it's a job that's on a movie set. But at the same time, the attention to detail carries over to, okay, if I'm working somewhere else, I got to make sure that I'm on my P's and Q's and
that
type of thing. So we've had guest speakers. We have one coming in regards to makeup. So we always are welcoming those to come check us out, even if they don't want to guest speak, just to observe and see what goes on in our environment.
Mm-hmm. I like how you actually put that far as an environment. There is, like you were saying, there is so much going on a film set. Whether it's an actual film or just a television show for that matter.
Exactly.
So I think having an overall range of those kind of speakers coming in, for them to even shadow a little bit or just actually get that experience in the classroom and apply it to their projects,
and
to their career-based experience, that's great. Because I myself, when I was on film set, I had no idea. I mean, I watched the behind the scenes on like DVDs and Blu-rays, but just actually being on site for that is just a completely different
It's a different animal.
It is.
It's not all limousines and
no.
you know red carpets and stuff like that.
No,
not at all. So, you know, it's 12, 14-hour days, building up your stamina, being on your feet for that amount of time. Mm-hmm. So, but at the same time, that's something you need to do in another job. If you, for example, if you were to work at a construction site, you're using your muscles, it's manual labor.
Yeah.
So, and that transcends into the film industry as well.
Yeah, there are a lot of variables involved.
So I can't stress just the real world applications that go into what we do. So I can't stress that enough.
Well, it sounds like your program definitely covers a lot of those aspects. So that's good for you guys. Good for you guys. Like I said, I'm even more of a fan of a Grizzly than I was previously, to be honest. We're going to actually take a quick break.
Okay.
So when we get back, we'll actually just go into the pretty much more of the internships, mentorships, and also how the community could actually get more involved, too.
All right.
Thank you.
Sounds great.
Yeah, so viewers, make sure you stay tuned. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back going over those details. All right, stay tuned.
From triggering an asthma attack. Learn how to stop their asthma attacks at noattacks.org.
Monsters can be anywhere.
How's everybody doing tonight?
Hello.
Chrissy, hey.
Hey, Alex.
How are you?
Alex? Alex? Hello.
Hi.
I'm Mrs. Garcia. We've heard a lot about you.
He is cute. Stop.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
Hello and welcome back to Community Connection. I'm your host Ian Jones, and we still have with us from Oakland University, Jay and Kristin from Oakland University, from the Center of Autism's Practical Film Workshop for Adults with Autism and Other Developmental Disabilities. So Jay, let's actually dive into, we were discussing the 20-week course program.
Yes, sir.
When will the next one actually be starting up, and about when will it be ending?
The next one ends at the end of this month, and we'll be starting the other one in the near future.
Okay.
So it'll be a chance for students to come in, enroll, and check out our services and the program. And we'll have more information on our website in regards to those stop and start dates. So they can definitely want to check out the OU Cares website for more information.
Okay, so you said the OU Cares website, and
yes, sir.
Is there a direct telephone number or email address that they would probably be able to reach somebody more directly to as well if need be?
Yes, that phone number would be 248.
248-370-2424. Our website is www.oakland.edu/OUCARES, which is OUCARES. Or you can always send us an email for more information at OUCARES@oakland.edu.
Perfect. Now, Kristin, since we're back on to you now, is there anything else that you would like to elaborate on as far as the OU Cares program in general?
Well, I just want everyone to know the fact that OU Cares is the Center for Autism Outreach Services at OU Oakland University. So we do offer, obviously we're extremely proud of this program, this practical film workshop for adults on the spectrum and other developmental disabilities, but we also offer a number of other programs and services for individuals from very young ages, ages 3 and up, all the way up through teens and adulthood, and families and educators and the community at large who might be interested in autism. So if you're interested in the recreational programs or the camps, or we have an evening enrichment series, lots of other kinds of things as well as our employable skills program and the film workshop, please contact us at that website I just mentioned, and we'd be happy to answer any questions.
Excellent. Now, this is actually just a personal question of mine. With this actually being affiliated with a university, regarding your social media, would any of these projects actually be uploaded to on your Facebook or even YouTube? Or
yes, we have an OU Cares, a Practical Film Workshop YouTube channel.
And oh, wonderful.
Forthcoming will be a OU Cares Practical Film Workshop Facebook page. So we did a cooking show. It was a take off the Big Bang theory. We call it the Big Spoon Theory. So some of those sessions are actually listed on our YouTube channel right now.
I love your catchy play on words there with those titles. No, the titles are everything too.
Definitely.
In addition to what Jay mentioned, we also, OU Cares in general has a Facebook page, and we try to put as many pictures and clips from the Practical Film Workshop on that as much as possible, as well as the OU Cares webpage. So we definitely are fully behind everything that we're doing at the Film Workshop.
Good. Now, just to backstep a little bit, Jay.
Yes, sir.
You mentioned when the classes actually start and when they end. Like, what would be the time frames of those classes? Like,
we're there Monday through Friday for 5 hours a day. Classes run from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Oh, not bad.
So, and we're at Meadow School in the Avondale School District. So.
Okay.
Which is up in Rochester.
Yeah, I'm pretty familiar with that area myself. Great sandwich place near the campus, the Bellas.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They do have a pretty good sandwich.
Yeah, they do. They do. One of the best, actually. So we're going to backpedal a little bit more. We mentioned we already actually covered the job training programs. But let's actually go into any kind of help you guys might be looking for as far as people looking for internships or how they can get more involved.
First, it's not a job training program, right? That's what we learned.
Right. technically.
It's a practical film workshop.
Practical film workshop.
Right.
So the training from that workshop.
Correct.
The internships that you would be looking for this training in this program.
Right.
How would someone, besides reaching out to your email or social media or just reach out to you, how would they actually get more involved that way?
We welcome, again, the solicitation of businesses in the area in regards to internships and just creating opportunities for our students to be in an element of productivity.
Okay.
So they can definitely reach out to the contact information that Kristin provided and check us our social media footprint as well. But I do welcome all companies in regards to internships that are willing, that need help, an extra set of hands. Again, just for the students to be in the environment of productivity is something that I encourage a relationship to make that happen.
Yeah, okay. We definitely want to find all or help them find jobs and put them in the right employment settings. So anybody who'd be interested, we'd love to hear from.
That's good. You know, I'm sure after today's segment that they definitely will most certainly be interested. I definitely recommend checking out that CNN. CNN video that you can find on CNN's website as well as YouTube, and definitely reaching out to Oakland University about this program in general, for sure. So with that being said, excuse me, anyone that's not necessarily interested in actually taking the classes, or just anybody from the community that is interested in actually getting involved because of what this department actually focuses on, Would you say that that also obviously applies to them too? Like, would there be other ways that they can actually get involved to kind of just help keep this program moving forward?
Definitely. In terms of volunteers for not only the practical film workshop, but for those that want to get involved with OU Cares, we're always looking for volunteers.
Definitely. Okay. The volunteer application can be found on the website. Mm-hmm. And I do want to just stress as well that the film workshop specifically is for anybody who'd be interested who would be an adult with developmental disabilities, including autism. Mm-hmm. So our application for the film workshop can be found on our website as well.
Good. But of course, I recommend checking out the campus too and just stopping on by. Definitely wouldn't turn that down.
Come on by.
Right? But like Jay mentioned, our film workshop is not located on campus. Many of our recreational programs for the Center for Autism are. However, the film workshop is off campus, and we've had been really great that we could find a site in the Meadows School District, the Avondale School District, that Jay mentioned. But like you said, we are also offering programs at the university.
Yes. Now, how far you said the Meadowdale area? How far is that away from actual OU's campus? Just ballpark mileage.
It's about a 15-minute ride.
That's not bad.
It's very close.
Very close.
Yeah.
Good.
So close to OU's campus. So.
Yeah.
Good. All in the family there. Love it.
There we go.
Love it. I noticed too, Kristin, I'm glad you brought it up, that we actually all are matching here today. That's pretty cool, right? Supporting the colors too.
There you go.
We did. Golden Grizzlies.
Yeah. Right. I think we're close to wrapping up here. So either one of you have any final thoughts or any other information that you would like to share with us today?
Just again, welcoming relationships with students and people in the community to let them know that we are a source for them. For if you have autism or any other developmental disability, for you to come and see what we're all about and out for you. So there are options out there for you. And at the same time, we're about increasing that quality of life, not only with the practical film workshop, but with OU Cares in general. So I want to stress that as well. So,
excellent.
And the fact that the individuals who come through our practical film workshop, they exceed all of our expectations in terms of what we're expecting them to do for the movies, and in terms of their interpersonal communication skills and their interactions and their social skills, they have been wonderful. And so anybody who'd be interested in bringing anybody from our film workshop into their employment setting, you will be completely blown away at the wonderful things that you will learn from the individuals who are on the spectrum or have other developmental disabilities. So definitely open up your doors, open up your hearts, because we're all always amazed at the wonderful things that they teach us and that they bring into our lives.
Yeah, that learning environment goes both ways, right?
Mm-hmm. Right about that, definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
No pun intended. So, last question, Jay, if you can,
sure.
Off the top of your head, quick tidbit on any particular projects or even guest speakers that will be coming up when classes actually begin again.
We have a photographer that frequently comes in and speaks to our students. We have a woman who's been a script supervisor who's been a guest speaker, and she's always eager to come back and speak to us, as well as a makeup artist that has been, or she'll be actually coming in and guest speaking. And when I mean guest speaking, it's not a formal outfit, you know, there's no suit and tie and all that type of thing. It's just sharing your experience as to what you've been through. Because aside from me always talking and our instructors, it's always great to hear from an outside source. So it's very informal. They can cover, you know, speak as long as they want. They're more than welcome to stay the whole term of, you know, when we're there for the day. But it's just, again, sharing their experiences, and how the students gravitate to them has been very great. I noticed they're very inquisitive as to the questions and things like that. Like, for example, we had a gentleman who worked on Batman Superman, and
no
he
way.
Came and spoke to one of the students, and he actually made a makeshift of Hollywood Walk of Fame for one of our students as well, which was really cool.
That is very cool.
The two of them bonded, and it was very cool for him to go out of his way and make the Walk of Fame. So, and again, it's just whoever wants to come speak just to share their experience in the world of work. So that's something that I encourage as well.
Oh, yeah, I definitely support that, absolutely. Right. So they would reach out to you the same way as anyone else from the community would like to get
involved.
Exactly.
So even Good if deal. You want to come and speak yourself, you're more than welcome.
Hey, I think I'll definitely be in touch with that for sure.
Definitely.
Yeah, I have a little insight to share and just to get that whole build the rapport with your group. Yeah. I think I would really enjoy a lot.
I love it. Great.
All right. We'll be in touch then.
All right.
And Kristin, do you have any other tidbits you would like to discuss regarding OU Cares? Or
I think we've covered everything that needs to be said. The only final thing I'll say one more time is our website. If you want more information, which is www.oakland.edu/OU Cares, or you can give us a call at 248-370-2424.
All right. Sounds good. Well, there you have it, folks. You heard it from the lion's mouth, in this case, a bear's mouth, of how you can reach out to Oakland University's this department in general, and also how you can reach out to Jake and Kristin. So,
Jay,
I'm sorry. That's you look like a Jake, but Jay's catchy, Jay, too. I know a lot of Jakes. So how you can reach out to Jay and Kristin. So that's all the time we have here. Thanks again for your time and for tuning in. And until next time, as always, take care.